Hello students, welcome to the another video of calculus. So in today's lecture we will discuss the definition of absolute value and see some properties of absolute value. So first of all, the definition of absolute value. Absolute value. So the definition of absolute value is, let A belongs to R, that is for any real number R, the absolute value, the absolute value of that number A is defined as, is, first of all we will take the notation, is suppose denoted as, absolute value of A is denoted as, absolute value means modulus, mod A, and it is defined as, and it is defined as mod of A is equals to, mod A is equals to, there are three possibilities for modulus, because if depending upon whether A is positive, negative or zero, if A is greater than 0, then modulus of A is equals to itself A, whenever A greater than 0. If A greater than 0, so we will take the two possibilities, A modulus of A is equals to A, whenever A is greater than or equals to 0. If A is equals to 0, then mod 0 is equals to 0. Again, if A is equals to 1, then mod 1 is equals to 1. If A is equals to 2, 3, 4, suppose A is equals to 10, then modulus of 10 is equals to again 10. So for a positive or non-negative real number, modulus of A is equals to A, and modulus of a negative number is equals to minus A, whenever A less than 0. For a negative number, modulus of A is equals to minus of A. So this will confuse you, because we know that the mod of any number, mod of any real number is positive number. So modulus of A must be a positive number, but by definition we get modulus of A is equals to minus A for A less than 0. So the example will clear that. So first of all, whenever A is equals to, first example is A is equals to 0, then mod A, which is equals to mod 0, is equals to 0. So here A is equals to 0, mod of A is equals to 0. So mod of A 0, mod of 0 is itself A. A is equals to 0 and this mod of 0 is equals to 0. In second case we will see, suppose A is equals to suppose number 10, then mod of that number A, which is equals to mod of 10, is equals to 10 itself. So A is equals to 10 and we get mod of A is equals to again 10. So for a positive number or a non-negative number, means for a number 0 or greater than 0, it will be clear, for suppose A is equals to some rational number, that is suppose 3.5, A is equals to 3.5, then mod of A, which is equals to mod of 3.5 is itself a positive number, so modulus of again that number is equals to 3.5. So A mod A is equals to A, mod of this A is equals to A itself, whenever our A is greater than or equals to 0. Now we will see the example of negative number. Suppose if A is equals to minus 2, then modulus of minus 2 will become 2, modulus of minus 2. We know that the modulus of negative number is positive number. So mod of minus 2 is equals to 2. So if we compare these two, then A is equals to minus 2 and 2 can be written as minus of minus 2. Here A is equals to 2 and mod A is equals to this minus of A is equals to minus 2, minus of A, mod A is equals to minus A, since this minus sign and A is equals to minus 2. So to get the value of negative number, modulus of negative number is equals to positive number, that is mod of minus 2 or mod of any negative number is positive number, we have to multiply that number by minus 1. So minus of minus 2, minus of minus 2 is our 2. So the modulus of negative number is positive number, but by definition we write it as mod of A is equals to minus of A, since in you consider suppose mod of minus 5, then we know that the mod of minus 5 is plus plus 5, but this plus 5 appears because here a is equals to minus 5. So as this a is equals to minus 5, so modulus of a will our modulus of minus 5, and that is plus 5, because plus 5 we write it this plus 5 because of minus of a, that is minus of here a is equals to minus 5, minus of minus 5 is plus 5. So this is the definition of absolute value or modulus of any real number. So don't make the confusion where this mod of a is equals to minus a. Mod of a is equals to minus a because our a was less than 0. So for a negative number, our modulus is positive, but that modulus positive because of we multiply that a itself by minus sign. Here a is equals to minus 5, and multiplying that minus 5 by minus 1, that or minus sign, we get minus of minus 5 is equals to plus 5. So this is the definition of absolute value. Now the next, some properties of absolute value. So first property is not or some property first property is mod of a into b is equals to mod a into mod b. Mod a b is equals to mod a into mod b. Second property is mod of a square is equals to a square itself for all a belongs to real number. For any negative positive real number, modulus of that number is positive and square of positive number is positive. And also we know that the square of any negative number or positive number is always positive. So mod of a square is equals to mod a square. Third property is if c is greater than or equals to 0, then mod of a is less than or equals to c. Mod of a is less equal c if and only if, this is notation of if and only if and only if and only if minus c is less equal a is less equal c. This is the important property. This c greater equal 0, then mod a less equal c if and only if minus c less equal a is less equal c. So to prove this property, or this is the explanation for the property, since we know that for any number a is a positive number, sorry, c is a positive number, c is greater than or equals to 0. So for any number a is less than or equals to c. Here we have given that a is less than or equals to c. We have to consider for in the first here the properties of the form if and only if. So we have to consider first part and we have to prove the second one, and in the converse part we will consider this and prove this. Now if our a is less than mod a is less than or equals to c, this mod a less equal c, then clearly we can see that this, if a is positive number, then a will less than or equals to c. Again if a is negative number, then that number will again minus a is less equal c. Since modulus of any number is less than or equals to c, because here c is the positive number, also mod of a, mod of any real number is positive number. So modulus of that positive number, sorry, modulus of that a is less than or equals to c means if a is itself positive number, then mod a is equals to a, so a is less equal c. And if this a is negative number, then negative number means again that minus sign, so minus of a is again less than or equals to c. For example, if you take the particular example, there is no need to write this example in this proof. Here if you take suppose mod of suppose minus 5 is less than or equals to, we say that 7, then this mod of minus 5 is 5, so clearly 5 is less equal 7, and also this minus 5 is less than or equals to 7. So mod a less equal c gives us a less equal c and minus of a less equal c. There is no need to write, this is just for your. Now we have this mod a less equal c gives us a less equal c and minus a less equal c. As this a is less than or equals to c, as a less than or equals to c, and this minus a is also less equal c, if we know that if we multiply this suppose is equality by minus sign, then we get minus of minus a is plus a, and if we multiply any inequality by minus sign, then that inequality gets changed, that is here less equal becomes greater equal, so minus c. If we multiply this inequality by minus sign, then this sign becomes reverse, that is a is greater equal c. So for example, here we have minus 5 less than or equals to 7, and if you multiply the both sides, then this 5 and this will become minus 7, and clearly our 5 is greater than or equals to minus 7. So if you multiply this inequality by minus sign, that sign reverses. Also, if we take the reciprocal, if you take the reciprocal, then also sign becomes reverse. So here we are multiplying this by this inequality by minus sign, so we get a greater than or equals to minus c. Now we have this a is less than or equals to c, and this minus c is less than, as this a greater means minus c is less than or equals to a. So combining these two inequalities, here minus c is less than or equals to a, minus c is less than or equals to a, and this a is less than or equals to c. So a is less than or equals to c, hence we get the required claim, that is in the this property we have given that mod a less equal c if and only if minus c is less than or equals to a less equal c. So in the first part we have considered this mod a less equal c, and we proved this minus c less equal a less equal c. In the converse part, this property, the third property, is important property. So in the converse part we will suppose this minus c less equal a less than or equals to c, minus c less than or equals to a less than or equals to c, and we have to prove that our claim is this mod a less than or equals to c, mod a less than or equals to c. Now we have this minus c less than or equals to a less than or equals to c, so we can split this minus c less equal a and a is less than or equals to c, minus c less equal a and this a less equal c, and we can just multiply this side, this inequality by minus 1, then we get this c is greater than or equals to minus 1, and this as it is, that is a less equal c. So we can rewrite these equations, these two inequalities, as this minus a is less equal c and this a is less than or equals to again c. So here from these two, that a is less equal c and minus a is less equal c, we can write directly modulus of, here minus a is less equal c, also a is less than or equals to c, if you take the modulus of a, then that will less than or equals to c, hence the proof of this property. We are directly writing minus a mod a less equal c, because here negative of a, if a is negative number, then minus a less than or equals to c. So if you take this modulus of this number, then mod of minus a will become plus a, and that plus a is less equal c, so mod a less equal c. Also for this a less equal c, modulus of a is equals to a itself and a is less equal c, so mod a less than or equals to c, hence the proof of the third property. Now the last property is a b c d. There is no need to prove the first two properties as well as the last one. The fourth property is minus of mod a is less than or equals to a, and which is again less than or equals to positive of mod a for all a belongs to real numbers. Minus of mod a less than or equals to a is less than or equals to c. If you want to prove this property, just take c is equals to mod a in the above property. If we put c is equals to mod a, then we get minus of mod a is less than or equals to a is less than or equals to mod a. Instead of c, you just have to write mod a. So minus of mod a less equal mod a. This is the proof of last property. There is no need to prove these properties. Now we will see another property or theorem, which is triangle inequality. So the next result is, or next theorem is, triangle inequality. Next theorem is triangle inequality. Triangle inequality. Triangle inequality. So the statement of the triangle inequality is, for all a comma b belongs to R, for all a comma b belongs to R, mod a plus b is less than or equals to mod a plus mod b. Again, this property is also important, or this triangle inequality is also important. Mod a plus b is less than or equals to mod a plus mod b. Now we will use the previous four properties. So to prove this triangle inequality, we will use the previous properties. Now from the previous theorem or the previous notes, we know that instead of writing from the previous notes, I will write the whole property. As we know that here we have given that a comma b belongs to R, and we have to prove that, that is our claim is mod of a plus b is less than or equals to mod a plus mod b. But we know that by the previous properties we have the last one as mod of, the last property was minus of mod a is less than or equals to a is less than or equals to this mod a. So using this result, we can write by the previous result, or by, or we know that minus of mod a is less equal a is less equal mod a. Here a is real number, similarly b is real number, so we can write this property for b as well. So mod of minus b is less equal b is less than or equals to mod b. Now we have these two equations, and if we add these two equations, suppose this is equation number 1 and this equation number 2, adding these equations, suppose this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2, adding equations 1 and 2, we get, so here we have to add this equation, means we have to add these two sides as well as addition of this and addition of these two. So we get minus of mod a plus minus of this first term, then another second term is minus of mod b is less than or equals to addition of these two, a plus b, this is less than or equals to a plus b is less than or equals to mod a plus mod b, mod a plus mod b. Now if you take the minus sign common, then we get mod a plus mod b is less than or equals to a plus b is less than or equals to mod a plus mod b, mod a plus mod b. So this is looking like minus of this c is less equal a is less equal plus c. C is equals to mod a plus b. If you take c is equals to mod a plus mod b, then this minus of c is less equal a is less equal c. Therefore by third property, or by, we know that, but we know that, but we know that if mod a is less equal c, if and only if minus c less equal a is less equal c. Here c is equals to this mod a plus mod b, a is equals to a plus b, and c is equals to again mod a plus mod b. So minus c less equal a less equal c will gives us mod of a. So here a is equals to a plus b, so this will give us mod of a, means mod of this number, mod of a plus b is less than or equals to c. C is this mod a plus mod b, mod a plus mod b. Hence the proof of triangle inequality. This is the important result. This question or this property may be asked for 3 marks or 4 marks if the examination holds offline. So in this property we have seen that AB, these two are real numbers, and this is our claim, means that is we have to prove this result, mod A plus B is less equal mod A plus mod B. But by previous properties or previous theorem, we have the fourth one as mod A is less equal A is less equal minus of mod a is less equal mod a. Similarly, we can use this property on b, that is minus of mod b less equal mod b. These two are first and second equations. Adding these two equations, we get this and this. After taking minus sign common, we get this as c, minus c less equal a less equal c gives us mod of a is less than or equals to c. So using that two properties, we can prove the triangle inequality, hence the proof. Also we will take two remarks. One remark is These also the properties of modulus. So first remark is mod of minus of sorry mod of mod A minus mod B. Modulus of mod A minus mod B is less than or equals to mod A minus B. Mod of minus mod of this subtraction, that is modulus of A minus modulus of B. Modulus of mod A minus mod B is less equal mod A minus B. And the second remark is mod of A minus B is less than or equals to mod A plus mod B. Mod A plus mod B. Now these properties we will use further for the next examples. So solving the next examples. Now we will take one example. The first example is again determine the set. So the next example is determine the set A is equals to. We have seen the similar examples before this in the previous lectures. So now the example is we have to find the set of real numbers x belongs to R such that real numbers satisfies this property. Mod of 2x plus 3 is less than 7. Mod of 2x plus 3 less than 7. Now to solve such examples we just take the element from that set. So therefore that element must satisfy the given property, that is 2x plus 3 is less than 7. Now we have the property mod A is less than or equals to C. So we can use that property. This will use minus C. Here C is equals to 7, A is equals to this. Mod A less than or equals to 7 means minus 7 strictly less than. Here less than sign given and we are using the property mod A less equal C. Mod A less equal C means mod A is either strictly less than C or equals to C. Less than or equals to. So or condition, so we can use for any of two conditions, that is if A is less than C or A is equals to C. So we can write that mod A less equal C. So minus 7 is less equal 2x plus 3 is less than, sorry not less equal, here minus 7 less than 2x plus 3 less than 7. So this satisfies me. This is if and only if mod A less than C, if and only if this is the sign of if and only if. Now if we subtract 3 from all 1, 2, 3 sides, then we get minus 7 minus 3 is less than 2x plus 3 minus 3 is 2x is less than 7 minus 3. So if and only if this minus 7 minus 3 will minus 10 is less than this 2x as it is less than 7 minus 3 is 4. So our x belongs to this set A if and only if that x is varies from 2x varies from minus 10 to 4 means if we divide throughout by 2 then we get minus 10 by 2 is minus 5 is strictly less than x is less than 4 by 2 is 2. So x belongs to set whenever our x is in between minus 5 to 2. So the given required set, sorry the required set is A x belongs to R such that x is in between minus 5 to 2. Minus 5 is less than x is less than 2. Hence the solution of this